Hey guys, welcome back to Clubhouse Kids. I'm going to be starting a new series on my channel where I will go through each of the categories that you can make deductions from within your home daycare. And so the two record-keeping books that I use every single year are made by Red Leaf Press, and I have talked about this one in the past. This is the Red Leaf Press Calendar Keeper. I purchased this at the beginning of every year. In this book, I have my calendar where I can write all the hours that I am open working with children and all of the hours that I work outside of watching the children. So all the time that I'm preparing lessons, cleaning up the classrooms, all those extra hours that you work outside of your 7 to 5, if that's the time that you're open. I record my clients' tuition. I can record my attendance. I can record all the meals that I have given the children. And then each month also has an expense report that I can go back on all my receipts and keep a running record of all the expenses from my daycare. So really purchasing this every year and staying up on it, because you do have to stay up on it and put your information in there, really puts you in a great spot for taxes and saves so much time at the end of the year when you're trying to gather everything up to do your taxes. And the second book that I purchase every year is the Red Leaf Press Tax Workbook and Organizer. Now, Red Leaf Press has two different ones. They have the workbook and organizer if you do your own taxes. So I do my own taxes. And then they also have another one that you purchase that is slightly different, that if you are going to give your taxes to a tax preparer, and so you can have everything for them to do your taxes. And so this is the one that I purchase every year. This is something that I pre-order from Red Leaf Press in about, I'm gonna say towards the end of October, beginning of November every year, so that when the first batch comes out, I'm already on that pre-order list and I get this enough time to be able to be ready to do taxes. In the past, I have ordered it one time on Amazon and I waited almost till the beginning of February to even receive this. If you order it through Red Leaf Press, you will have to pay shipping. So that'll be the difference between Amazon Prime or Red Leaf Press. The price itself doesn't change, but you're gonna get your book a couple weeks earlier, which for me is worth it because it is a pretty good size book and every year I do go through it and make sure that I'm ready for taxes. And so I thought over the next couple weeks I could just go through each of my main categories that I deduct from. So with Red Leaf Calendar Keeper, in the expense report, the different categories that they give you are advertising, insurance, interest, legal and professional services, office expenses, rent of business property, repair and maintenance, supplies, miles, taxes and licenses, travel and entertainment, food, toys, household items, cleaning supplies, and activity expenses. Now, I will say that a lot of these categories are blank for me. Most of these categories, I don't have anything in them. But that doesn't mean that you don't. I'm just gonna go through my categories that I use all the time, my most popular categories. So with this video, I'm going to start with food because food is probably one of my main deductions that I take every year. So if you are interested in knowing how to deduct your food expenses, I'm gonna show you how I do mine. Okay, so there are two ways you can deduct food expenses. You can take your actual food expense, where you keep all your receipts through the whole year and deduct that amount that your daycare kids ate. Now, for home daycare, I feel like this one can be a little bit challenging because our daycares are in our home. And so a lot of us buy our groceries with our family's groceries. A lot of us have younger kids that are in our daycares and they're eating that food as well. And it can get kind of challenging how to separate those receipts from your family's receipts and your home daycare receipts. Now that is not impossible. In the past, I have separated my groceries where I would go to the grocery store and get my daycare groceries, and then I would go to the grocery store and get my family's groceries. And I know some people do that too. You might have a separate area in your home where the daycare groceries go. You might not have any kids at your home, your own children, and so you can very easily separate and know exactly how much your daycare groceries are at the end of the year. For me, I feel like it's easier for me to take the standard deduction. So that is the second option. So you take your actual deduction or you take your standard deduction. And a standard deduction is you are just going to count how many kids are participating in every meal and snack, and then you're going to multiply that by the standard deduction at the end of the year. So for 2020, the standard deduction is every breakfast you serve, you get to deduct $1.33. Every lunch that you serve, you get to deduct $2.49. Every dinner that you serve is also $2.49. And then every snack that you serve is 74 cents. Now this year, my group that I have are all here for breakfast, they're all here for lunch, and they're all here for snacks. And so I do not have to take a separate meal form. In the past, when I had school age kids that would, you know, have breakfast at my home and then go to school and then come back for PM snack, or if they had a day off, then they would be having for lunch. My meal counts would end up being different per meal or snack that I served. This year, it has not. And so that has been a little bit easier. So I take my meal count right off of my attendance, because I know if they're here for the day, they're gonna eat breakfast with us, they're gonna have AM snack with us, they're going to have lunch, and they're gonna have a PM snack, is how what I serve in my daycare. So what I do at the end of every month is I grab my calendar keeper and I go to my attendance form that is in here, and I literally just count each child how many days they attended that month, and then I just start multiplying that out by how many breakfasts they were served, how many AM snacks they were served, how many lunches they were served, and how many PM snack they were served. And then I use the form that is in this workbook and organizer. And I will just show you guys, because this one is all ready to go. And so for in January, I served 96 breakfasts, 96 lunches, and 192 snacks. And then I just go through all of the months, because you can see that April and May I was completely closed, and then lunches and snacks. And then on down here, I do the total of breakfasts, where 601 times $1.33 is $799.33, 601 lunches and snacks. So my total food deduction for 2020 comes to $3,185.14. Now this is the number that I will put on my Schedule C miscellaneous other. Now how I categorize it is I put home, daycare, food. I like to categorize instead of just saying food, because I don't want to get mistaken with daycare, like entertainment meals or business meals or anything like that. So I always label it home, daycare, food. Now I was on the food program for January, February, and March, so I will go over what that looks like. Once I shut down in April and May, once I opened back up again, I went opted out of the program. I was kind of on my way out anyway. My rep that I was working with had retired, and so I decided that at that point I was just gonna step away from the food program, but I was involved with it for Monday, or for January, February, and March. And so I was part of daycare resources. In the mail, I received this little form here, and basically it just shows what I received from daycare resources. Now for me, I don't claim my own children, and so I can take this number exactly and just put this straight onto my income. And so I do make the complete deduction for my food expenses, and then I place this amount of money on my as income. And on that income, because the way I do my income is I put the family's last name and then how much they paid me for each year, I would just put daycare resource food program and then how much I received from that. So that is how I do my food expenses. Let me talk through a couple of things that I have done in the past. I used to do a parents' night out once a month. I'd no longer do that, but when I did that, and if I served a snack or a dinner during that time, then you would also claim that as another meal in your program. If you have any birthday treats, you can count that as an additional snack. For the IRS, you can claim up to 3 meals and 3 snacks per day. So that is different from the food program where you can only claim up to 3 food components. So when I was on the food program, I did breakfast, lunch, and PM snack on the food program. But then for my food expenses on my taxes, I always serve that additional morning snack. So if you are serving more snacks than what you are doing on the food program, you can count those on your taxes as well. Another example would be 2 years ago, I had one little girl that did not get picked up until 5:30 p.m. Now, I normally close at 5. It's something that I worked out with her parents, but at 5 o'clock, she got an additional snack just because that 5 to 5:30 was made for a very long day and she was starting to get hungry. And so I did an additional snack. So that year on my taxes, I had for her, she would get one extra additional snack than the rest of the kids. So I hope this clarified how to deduct your food expenses on your taxes. My next video, I will be talking about another category that I deduct for within my daycare. If you guys have any additional questions, we can get a conversation going in the comments. I would love to answer you any questions you guys have down there. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.